Hey everybody, it's Samira. Welcome back to the SEScoops YouTube channel. Today joined with me, I have MLW host Alicia Atout. Alicia, welcome on.
Hi, hello, hello, how are you?
I'm doing good, how are you doing?
I'm pumped, I'm psyched. So many great things are on the horizon, which I know we'll dive into, so I won't get into it, but yeah, it's a really good time right now.
We got MLW coming to Philadelphia this Saturday. How excited are you to come back to the States and work in-person shows again?
I can't even put it into words. Like, we've kind of spoken about this on your show and just conversationally, you and I. And I haven't had an actual live show since September of last year. So I'm coming up fairly quickly on a year of no shows, no crowds, nothing. And I miss it so much. Of course, we've been able to film a lot of stuff remotely, which I'm very grateful for. I've been hosting stuff weekly for MLW, but it's not the same. Like, when you're in person and this show will actually have fans for the first time in over, oh gosh, since March of 2020, our last show with fans was in Tijuana, Mexico. So it's insane to think about. It's going to be packed. It's sold out. We have a completely renewed, you know, roster. And it's just, I'm so excited. I could cry. I'm going to cry probably. Like, as soon as I hit that stage, I'm just going to cry.
Now, who do you think is going to win the Battle Riot?
That's so hard. Okay. So right now, and as much as I really don't want to choose someone from this faction, I feel like a lot of eyes are on Hammerstone at the moment, you know? So many people are wondering, when is he finally going to go one-on-one against Fatu? Is he going to potentially hold the open weight along with the heavyweight championships? But I just feel like he has been busting his chops every single day. When I'm opening Instagram, I'm seeing him like in the gym 10 times a day. He knows what he's been working on. And I think he's going to come in just like swinging. So I think it might be Hammer, but I'm not sure. I really don't know.
So how are you feeling now that your frenemy, Salina De La Renta, is gone from MLW? Do you miss her at all?
Oh, I mean, now that we're more in the frenemy stage, I do miss her a little bit, but I won't miss her really rude glares from across the room. I won't miss her cutting me off in interviews. I won't miss her just not showing up to my interviews. How rude. So it's going to be definitely very refreshing not seeing her face there and not having to worry about it. But then again, we do have a lot of new faces. Of course, some similar ones I don't see eye to eye with either. So we're just going to walk in there feeling positive, and hopefully everyone will be respectful and not rude to me. A little hint to somebody if he's ever watching it, but yeah, hopefully it'll go smooth sailing with everyone. I'm sure it will.
So we all heard that NWA is having their Empower All Women's pay-per-view coming up. Could we possibly see you there at Empower?
So as of right now, no plans. I mean, you never know what's going to happen, but as of right now, all I can really say is not at the moment, not anything that's been in talks as of yet.
You now dyed your hair green from what we all could see, and it's very nice. What inspired you to do so?
So funny enough, it's fading very, very much. You can kind of see when I put it close. Like, before it was super vibrant, but I have commitment issues, so I told myself I'm not going to do like a permanent dye. This was a semi one, washes out within 2 weeks, la-di-da. So today I actually have a hair appointment to spice things up for tapings, so I think I'm going to go au naturel for those, because these are the first tapings that are going to air on Vice TV. I want to look real nice and fancy, but the real reason I wanted to get it done is because ever since kind of working for Knotfest, which is one of my newer hosting gigs, since working for them and for Slipknot, I just kind of have been tapping into like my inner metalhead and the emo kid that's always been inside me since I was a teenager. And I just thought, what fun would it be to just dye my hair and kind of get back to like what the young me always wanted to do. So it was just kind of one of those little random ballsy things I decided to have done over the weekend, like a couple weekends back, and now we're here.
And what's it been like working with Knotfest?
Blows my mind. Like, never do you think that a band like that would put together such a great team thinking, hey, we want you to be a part of it. So it's been amazing. And then come end of September, we have our massive, massive show with a bunch of incredible bands. We have Slipknot headlining, Megadeth, Trivium, Lamb of God. Like, it's just insane. That show, it's September 25th, and I get to be there in person in Iowa doing some hosting. It's going to be packed. Like, it's gonna be incredible. My first concert in more than 2 years. And then I actually get to hit the road with them for about 5 days after. So I get to go on like a little mini tour with some of the coolest bands in the world. So yeah, it's been amazing. It's a huge opportunity. I love it. I'm learning about all these great bands along with being able to just chat about ones I've loved for years. So yeah, incredible opportunity.
It sounds very exciting. Is there one band that you're really hoping to like interview when you get to Iowa?
Honestly, it's interesting because I've interviewed Corey Taylor before, front man to Slipknot, but it'd be really cool to have like a couple of them. Of course, there's 9 members in the band, so coordinating all 9 might be a little tricky when it's like their biggest show of the year. But I would love to, even if I could get a photograph with all of them and stuff and just like blast it everywhere, that would make my day. So I definitely would love to catch up with Slipknot at the show. But again, there's so many great bands on it. And then when we hit the road, we have Killswitch Engage, Code Orange, Fever 333. So just a lot of stacked lineups with a lot of like very eclectic groups on it. So I'm psyched. It's gonna be heavy.
So I know we discussed this on my channel before. I thought I'd bring it over here and we talk about 90 Day Fiancé. Did you watch the recent one with Big Ed and the new girl that he was with?
So I didn't watch the ones that have suddenly moved to Discovery Plus, right? They have it on that. So yeah, I have not paid the $5.95 or whatever to dive into those new ones, but I see all the social stuff and I just see how much of a mess it is still for everybody. But I was watching Happily Ever After, which I was so sad they didn't air last night, but hey, it is what it is. But I've been watching that and I cannot believe how almost every single relationship is in shambles. And just when you think people are picking up the pieces, like one of the two people just act absolutely manic and completely out of character and just like, just douches. It's been so much fun to watch. I'm obsessed with it. And then I just got my kick of the new Too Hot to Handle season. I'm waiting for the new Love is Blind to drop. Like, I'm reality TV mode right now. It's horrible.
Oh my god, it's definitely the best. I just got done watching Too Hot to Handle too, and I was just like, yes. It was really good. They definitely spent more money this time than the first season.
It's like, come on, like, I don't understand it, like, that's not my vibe, but honestly, as I was watching it with my sister the whole time, and it's like, you're watching it, and you're disgusted, and you're repulsed, and you feel all these really, like, weird emotions you don't want to feel, but at the same time, you can't look away, because it's so baffling how these people's, like, their minds work and everything, so, yeah, it was a really good season. I can't wait for the next one, because it's good entertainment. It's stupid, but it's good entertainment.
Now, do you also like The Circle? I knew I really was a fan of that, and it blew up this time over of the second season.
Yeah, I really liked The Circle, and then I dove into the most recent season. I think it was the second one, right? Because they also did, like, France and all these other crazy places.
Yeah.
But I know there were a bunch of international ones, but I watched the latest US one, and there were so many twists and turns that put in there. Like, I was not expecting that towards the end, or people being eliminated and coming back, and I won't spoil anything for those who haven't watched it, but yeah, it was great. I thoroughly enjoyed that one. And then I just started, maybe like two months ago, my sister and I started watching The Bachelor and Bachelorette, and that's like a whole other rabbit hole of just, oh, people are so ridiculous and grody, but I don't know, it's just a next level entertainment. So that's where my downtime's been going to. Reality TV and murder documentaries.
Oh, the best. Oh my gosh, I swear, we're like twins.
Yeah, it's so funny, like whether it's food, sometimes like music, a lot of the television we watch, very much on the same.
Yeah. So as we're now, like you mentioned food, now you're coming to Philly, are you gonna have a famous Philly cheesesteak at all?
So what's funny is growing up, I had this family trip to Philly, maybe when I was like 16 years old, and I devoured them. My family would always make fun of me because I had the appetite of a glamazon. Like, I could eat so much. I put down 2 Philly cheesesteaks in one sitting. And the thing is, now my appetite and just what I love eating has changed so much. So I don't know. I'm not a huge fan of sandwiches anymore. However, a lot of the guys I've been speaking with, they're telling me, oh, we have this great spot, we gotta hit up, we have this spot. So I'll probably end up taking along for the ride and trying one of their spots out, if it's one I haven't had before. But, you know, I don't dislike them, but everyone gets it wit. And I'm not a fan of, like, that nacho, like, creamy cheese. That's not my thing. So we'll have to see. I might get some, like, provolone and onions on it or something. Go a little less classic, a little less traditional.
Yeah, you got the famous rivalry across the street from each other. You got Pat's or Gino's. And then some people, they don't even deal with them. They go to Tony Luke's or there's another place. Is there a specific place you know that you're going to go to or you're just up in the air?
So I don't know yet. A couple of the boys, like, I was talking to them and texting, and they said, oh yeah, we're gonna go to a special spot we heard was great, but I have no idea what the spot is. I just said, all right, I'll come with you and we'll see where the day takes us. But I don't know. I do know, though, the funniest thing is every time I travel to Philly, there's a Tony Luke's in the Philly airport. So my dad always says, you have to bring me back something. So I always bring him back cheesesteaks from the airport, which sounds ridiculous, but it's like a little gift when I come home.
Alicia, thank you so much for joining us on SEScoops today. And you'll see Alicia at MLW Battle Riot 3 in Philly on Saturday night. Thank you so much for joining us. Can you tell everybody here where they can find you?
Yes, absolutely. So you guys can just follow me at Alicia Atout across all platforms. Every single one is verified. So just hop on, follow, say howdy. Of course, MLW will be airing brand new tapings from our tapings at the 2300 Arena this Saturday, July 10th in Philly. So excited, guys. But yes, you can watch the aired tapings from that every single Saturday at 12 p.m. So we have that nostalgic noon spot on Vice TV. We're also going to be airing everywhere else, YouTube. We're on Fubo, we're on so many different streaming platforms, which is amazing. So yeah, just Google MLW, you'll find us. We got some big plans. Oh, and then KnotFest every single weekday. Watch me on KnotFest Twitch channel, of course. Man, it still feels so fresh and exciting. It's on at 4 p.m. EST, 1 p.m. PT, so be sure to tune in if you happen to just love music and really good conversation.
And the best thing, MLW got sold out for Saturday night, so it's gonna be a full house.
I'm pumped. I'm so excited. I just want to hear the roars, the boos, everything in between. It's going to be amazing.
So everybody, you can find her socials, KnotFest, MLW, all linked in the description below, as well as mine at SEScoops. Again, Alicia, thank you so much for joining us today.
Absolutely. It's always such a delight. Thank you for having me.
Of course.